Hey Holly Stars, you're watching a cool video from Mr. Hollywood.
Also, please don't forget.
So after Dr. Seuss's wife said that there will be no more live action versions of the Dr. Seuss's books, in 2008, they made an animated version. And that's the one that we're reviewing today. Is it any good? Well, after this intro, I'll tell you all about it. Yo, honey stars, what's up? It's your boy, Mr. Hollywood, and welcome back to Mr. Hollywood's Retro Review. It's been a long time coming since I've done any of these. So, without further ado, as you can tell by the intro and probably by the thumbnail of this video, I am going to be reviewing and breaking down the movie
Seuss's
Horton Hears A Who is a 2008 computer animated adventure comedy film that is based on the book of the same name by Dr. Seuss. The film is directed by Jimmy Haywood and Steve Martineau. Have you pronounced his last name? I'm sorry if I butchered it if I did. The film's music is done by John Powell, the same guy who did the Ice Age sequels, Run East 2 and 3, and 4, not so much 5, but there you go. Anyway, the film features the voices of Jim Carrey and Steve Carell, and a few others you might recognize. Now, I know what you are thinking. You're probably wondering to yourselves right about now, Mr. Hollywood, what's the plot or what's the premise about Horton Hears A Who? I mean, what's it all about, you may be asking yourselves. Well, have no fear, my honey stars, because Mr. Hollywood is here once again to break down the plot for the movie. And the movie is, of course, Horton Hears A Who. So let's get right into the story, shall we? It's about an elephant named Horton who finds a speck of dust floating in the jungle of Nool. Upon investigation of the speck, Horton discovers that tiny city of Who-ville and its residents, the Who's, which he can hear but cannot see. Horton forms a friendship with the mayor of Who-ville, named Ned McDodd, and promises to transport Who-ville to safety. However, Horton encounters an opposition from his jungle neighbors, who doesn't want to believe in the existence of Who-ville. So Horton has to prove to the Jungle of Nool that Who-ville is an exact place and he's not going crazy and he can actually hear them and, well, find a safe spot for the Who-ville people on the speck and pretty much everything be a bygone type of thing. So, let's continue on with this review. Alright, so I already talked about the plot for Horton Hears A Who. What are my overall thoughts and are there any pros and cons with it? Okay, so here are my thoughts on Horton Hears A Who. And oh man, now this movie is actually not that bad. It's actually very entertaining and pretty enjoyable. And a fun film to watch, too. I think I said that twice, but whatever. Let's start off with the animation. The animation is, of course, very good. is very good, considering of what we had to go through with the live action Dr. Seuss versions of How the Grinch Stole Christmas, which wasn't really all that bad, but when I was a kid, I was terrified of the Grinch. Yeah, take that as it will. And then, of course, we have the horrors, that is the kind of hat.
That is disgusting.
I got a burp.
I am going to puke my guts out.
Yeah, just looking at that poster right now just gives me chills. Whew. And I'm sorry if I showed you that poster. That hideous poster. Anyway, back to Horton Hears A Who. I like the animation here. The animation is very stylized, and the character animation is very good as well. And each of the characters have their own different design. Like, I love how the Who's are actually very animated very well. And the road of Who-ville is actually very good. It's actually more, I would say, Dr. Seuss-like. As far as the jungle is concerned, the jungle is okay. It's whatever, you know. But I'm not going to fault them for it, no. Because Blue Sky animation as a whole, they do fantastic. I mean, they don't do fantastic animation as much as Pixar does. I mean, Pixar is phenomenal. Blue Sky, on the other hand, does a very decent job. Especially with the Ice Age films. And with this one, it's no exception. I remember I saw this movie, not in theaters, but I saw it on DVD. I actually own it on DVD. And there was a show called Surviving Sid, and that was actually very hilarious. just think about it now, it's hilarious. Now, let's get to the voice cast. The voice cast is actually very good. Steve Carell, playing a male, is always so funny, but yet charming, and you feel very sad for him, too. And, of course, with Holden. Holden is just played by, of course, Jim Carrey, who does phenomenal as the voice of Holden. And just like, and he's actually very funny. Seth Rogen is in here as Mutant, or whatever. He does a good job. He's just playing Seth Rogen. And Kate Winslet, now, before playing Hannah, she was the voice of the kangaroo. You know, that mean old kangaroo in the Jungle of Nool. I didn't know that she was, the first time I've heard of Kate Winslet's voice was from this movie, Horton Hears A Who. And many years later, I didn't know that she would be playing Hannah in Dol Ragnarok, so that's good. That's very good. Anyway, that does it for the voice cast. Well, Jesse McCartney's in here, but he doesn't really say all that much. And Jonah Hill is in here as well. He plays Timmy, you know, the orange creature. And yeah, that's all I got to say. Winnie about the voice cast. They all do fantastic. They all do good in this film. Now, let's get to the music. The music is, of course, created by John Powell. I can't really pronounce his name. John Powell. Okay, now I pronounce his name right. My gosh. Anyway, him as a composer is actually very good, especially in these Blue Sky movies. I know he did the Ice Age sequels. I believe he did Ice Age 1, Ice Age 2, Ice Age 3, and Ice Age 4. I don't think he came back for Ice Age 5, which was very sorely missed. I hope he comes back for Ice Age 6. But anyway, he does a good job here. And the music is very triumphant sometimes. And the music can sometimes be, okay, kind of dull. But sometimes it can be very grand and epic, and sometimes it can be, pretty emotional at times. Like where he, well, there's a scene where Horton loses the clover, and it, the music behind him is just so emotional and so impactful. But you know what's gonna happen. And right now, what's gonna happen is I'm gonna show you a clip from the movie. Oh, I totally forgot. I forgot to mention the pros and cons. Actually, I talked about the pros already. The only cons I gotta say, maybe this is a con, but I don't know. However you interpret it, I guess. There's one where, I'm trying to think, there was an anime part sequence. I'm not sure why that's there. I'm not a fan of anime, so I can't really tell you if I was mad at this film. I mean, for doing that. I'm just like, okay, this is unnecessary. Why do you need to put this in here? But as far from that, I guess, this is actually a pretty good film. I really do enjoy it. And I still love rewatching it, like, time after time again. Like I said before, I'm a fan of animation. And this one is good enough. My grading for this has got to be a B. It is a very good film. And my recommendation, I would say see it. I would say absolutely see it. If you love Dr. Seuss, and if you love animation, if you love Blue Sky, and if you... Then, yeah, this is definitely worth the watch. Well, Honey Stars, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Mr. Hollywood's Retro Review of my review on Horton Hears A Who. Not tongue twisted out, but you know what? I'm real. Get up. Anyway, I hope you guys really enjoyed this episode. And yeah, next week I'll be reviewing the Norax. So, yeah. Anyway, guys, drop a huge knock on this bad boy if you guys really enjoyed this video. Comment down below and let me know your thoughts on Horton Hears A Who if you have seen it. And what is your favorite Blue Sky animated film? Mine has got to be the Ice Age series, okay? I know I'm a hypocrite, but hey, I just love them. They're good to presents for me. And I will get to those Ice Age videos probably sometime next week or something. I don't know. Make sure to hit me up on all my social media accounts. All the links are in the description. So you can add me, follow me, so that way you can stay in contact with me. And that way you can get more information on the videos that I'm uploading and the future videos that I'm planning to do for this channel. Also, if you want to, you can add me on Discord. If you want to stay connected with me, I actually have a fan base called the Honey Stars server. It should be in the description, the link anyway. So if you guys want to join, you guys are free and welcome to. And make sure to share this video with all your friends. Let them know that Mr. Hunter exists and that I post daily. That's right, Honey Stars. I upload daily. And that is for any new Honey Star that has just subscribed to the channel. And if you guys want to subscribe to the channel, you guys can. I upload videos like the Star Wars videos, the MCU videos, the Disney videos, the Pixar videos, the Ice Age videos, anything having to do with movies and entertainment, you can mostly find on this channel, and I'm the type of guy that would do it. So, this Saturday I'm going to be reviewing The Stray, a fan request. So if you guys have any movies that you guys want me to review, leave it down in the comments below and I will definitely shout you out and I'll definitely review that movie. So The Stray was requested from a guy named Nate Movie Reviews. He's a pretty awesome YouTuber. Just go check him out. Right now, he's at 200 subscribers plus. So go check him out. I'll also leave a link to in the description so you guys can go check out his channel. With all that said and done, I'm Mr. Hollywood. Until my next review, I'm saying stay golden on my honey stars.
Hello, Payne the Nerd here. Make sure to like and subscribe down below for more content and become part of the Holly Stars.